This is James and Danny with an expert walkthrough of Watch Dogs Legion. Sorry, what's wrong with my mouth? The expert being Danny, and he's guiding me through the streets of London. You know what I didn't realize? Oh, I thought a timer was going down on this mission. Go ahead.
No, I was just saying it's a pleasure as always to guide you through the mean streets of London. There is no timer though, so we can head to the mission at a leisurely pace.
Yeah, I was going to say, a lot of times I think we're going to start off by getting some data to warm up, but since we're actually continuing on the previous day's recording, because there was some issues, blah, 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 I don't need any warming up. I think I'm ready to just get over there and start this heist mission.
Auto drive now.
And for you, Danny, I'll do auto drive.
No, well, we'll... You're right. It'll take forever if we do auto drive.
No, Danny. You really want it, so we'll do auto drive. It's better driving. So, are you happy now?
You like a petulant child sometimes. I mean, like, you know, it's the blue and white thing, and now you're just like, you know, bringing the auto drive thing back into it, and.
Well, I just want you to appreciate my driving for what it is. It may be messy, but it is efficient, and it's quick, and sometimes you got to give somebody a little bump. You call it the James Heaney bump.
Okay, I agree never to question your driving again.
Thank you.
I may wince at the camera, but I won't say it out loud.
Well, that'll work for me. It seems like it's guiding me over here, but isn't the mission behind me?
Yeah, but London's full of one-way streets, if you remember, so, like...
Oh, wait, anyway. Is that Arrow? I think we're there. That's the military people, okay. So what is that little thing? Okay. Oh, what is this? Is this an ATM?
No, so this is like... This is like a little side mission thing you can do, where you can do deliveries of packages. We can give that a try once you've done this mission, if you like.
Sure, I'll give one a try afterwards, but I don't want to leave my my other cohort hanging, because I think we're doing a heist together, right? Or is it just me doing a heist?
So in the story, it's like a team effort, so you kind of switch characters somewhat through it, if I recall. But you do all the gameplay, so...
I'll highlight the server with the AR reconstruction software.
Ooh.
It's out of reach, so you'll need to use a heavy cargo drone to steal it.
Oh. So, do I get on top of the cargo drone?
You do indeed. And then you hack it to take control of it.
And because I'm in a construction outfit, this is normal. Nobody's going to think this is suspicious. Oops.
Oh, no, they think you're dodgy as fuck. But, I mean, you can do it. You can actually call the thing in the first place. Also, it goes a lot faster if you're playing as the construction worker.
Oh, that's good. All right, so this is pretty simple. Just head over here. This is kind of neat. For some reason, this reminds me a little bit of Infamous. Is that what the game was called on PlayStation?
Yeah, Infamous. Yep, and the second one, Infamous 2. And I think there was a few others after that, but yeah, anyway.
Was there? I think there might have been like a DLC added on, but I think there was only two Infamouses.
Yeah, potentially. I don't know. I think we've already established that. I don't actually know what I'm talking about. It is a restricted space, but, you know, you're on a drone, so I just nip in, grab it, and just run away. That would be my advice to you.
Okay. You said nip him?
Well, nip in,
like distract
which is
him?
A British way of saying, no, just, you know, just go in quickly and just grab it and leave. Like, don't even worry about the guy, because he's not facing you anyway.
Okay. What do I do? Attach it?
So if you just... There you go.
Well, now I've just nipped him. I just nipped him. Bring it this way.
Well,
so go ahead and tell me what that means in British. What does it mean to nip somebody again?
Well, you don't nip a person, you nip in. So, like, I am nipping into the shops is like I am quickly going into the shops. Sorry, I probably wasn't very clear in what I was trying to say there.
No, it's great. This is great. I'm learning a lot. I'm getting very cultured. If I was to be like, oh, Danny, I brought my friend over to your house and you really nipped him, that would be like either you physically were like attacking him or maybe you were being like mean to them and saying like little snippy, like, well, maybe the word I'm looking for is snippy. I went ahead and loaded the server in Chirwide.
It's up to you now. Yeah, well, you mean like if a dog nips you, that's like
yeah,
if a dog
exactly.
bites you.
Still can't believe I let a fucking computer talk me into this. Cheers, mate.
Oh my god, this voice. It's the worst character.
It really stands out when you hear other people talk. Like, if you just hear him for a while, you forget. But when he interacts with somebody else, that voice becomes really awkward. AR reconstruct.
It's ridiculous, right?
Yeah.
It's like the other characters are like, hi, how are you? And then this guy's just like, I'm okay, how are you? I'm all right, thank you.
We are anonymous. We do not forgive. We do not forget.
Yeah, that's actually weird. Quite appropriate for this game, but yeah.
Download complete. I need a wider sample of data, so I'm pushing
you the coordinates to a new location. Ooh, maybe this guy is the guy who does the voices for all the dead sex stuff.
Wouldn't that be
That is the plot twist right there. That is the plot twist. I think we've cracked it, James. We know what's going on.
My guess is I'm not allowed to just use auto drive with this. This is brilliant. Oh yeah, yeah. It's compiling data from the surveillance infrastructure, nearby CTOS drones, civilian optics, CCTV, and then it assembles those scraps into what happened in this location 24 hours ago. Fantastic. These people, even though I'm in auto drive, are really afraid of me. All right, so I guess I'll try.
Yeah,
to go
probably
a
with good
faster.
Reason. Well, you're on an open road. You might as well just gun it, James. Go for it.
Yeah. And then when I get here, I'll put it back on auto drive. Whoa!
That didn't work.
What happened? I had it on auto drive.
I don't know whether I regret introducing you to auto drive at this point. I think it might just be better if you just drive.
I don't know. I like auto drive. I just need to get going really nice and fast. Okay, here it is. So I use cruise control a lot, and sometimes it bothers my wife, but I have a Subaru Forester, and it's got EyeSight. Have you heard of this before, or did I tell you about it?
Is that the thing where it just brakes automatically for you, like if you're getting too close to the cars?
It brakes. It does a lot of things automatically. It kind of just locks into the car in front of you and keeps you that distance from them. It doesn't take turns for you. But if you're turning on a street and the street is turning and the lines on the street are turning as well, it turns your car for you and keeps you in the lines, which is really awesome. But it also, like, you've got to pay attention because if you're going around a turn that is too steep, it will make you it'll make you crash because it can't follow along.
Okay, that sounds scary and not at all
disingenuous. I like it. I drove across the country with it. It's amazing. You can basically, like, go to the... If you're on a long, straight highway, like you see across the Midwest, you can get up and go to the back of your car, get yourself some food. It's scary for the passengers, sure, but as long as you know that there's no turns coming up, you're fine.
I was going to say, like, it sounds like a really good idea for driving down freeways and stuff, but, like, in LA city traffic, do you even get a chance to use that very often?
It actually is surprisingly almost better in LA city traffic, because the traffic in LA is sometimes so gridlocked, which now I've only had this car since the summer, so I haven't driven much except for across the country during the summer. But on the couple, like, I got a COVID test back in July, and in order to get that test, I was in like 2 hour traffic of like going around this little like parking lot that they had snaked around. Putting on my EyeSight, I didn't even have to look. It would just like bing when the car in front of me moved. I'd tap the gas, and then it would just keep me in the loop. I barely had to do anything. I could read, I could do whatever I wanted, and it just kept me in the right position.
I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to read. Please tell me you weren't reading books.
I mean, I wasn't reading books, that's for sure. But I was reading some stuff. I was reading stuff.
For fuck's sake, James, I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to do that, even if it is an auto-driving car. I'm sure you're supposed to keep an eye on the road in case it's like, you know, an emergency or like, you know, oh my god, you scared.
Well,
you know
what?
Like,
you don't understand the context. It was in like a, it was like a standstill line. So most of the time,
okay,
I was just not moving at all. And because it was in line, we were taking COVID tests from our car and pulling up to like a thing. So it was like two hours that I was driving around in this little tiny like stop and go parking lot. So it's there.
Okay, if you were stopped in traffic and reading between, yeah, that's fine. What I thought you meant was you were just cruise controlling down the freeway while you had like Jane Austen in one hand and your mobile in the other. And you were just kind of like, you know, keeping yourself busy. It's like the car's doing all the work. And I'm like, oh my, you know what I mean? Like, it's just, do you drive cars like you play video games? Like, are you trying to get yourself killed?
Well, not when I have a Subaru Forester with eyesight. It's actually a lot better. Look at that car. What is that car doing? Is that a bad guy?
He must be using his eyesight or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I guess you're right. He might not be as bad a guy as he seems right now. Oops.
He was just reading a brochure, and you know, the next thing you know, he slammed into the back of somebody. Just like, I don't know how.
Well, that's the thing, is that would never happen on a Subaru eyesight. It would stop you. Can I just cut through there?
Except, but they're not perfect though, are they? Like they sometimes screw up, from what I understand. Or have you found that it just works? Well, I mean, by your own admission, it has the ability to just drive you into a wall if you take too steep of a turn.
Well, so, not into a wall. It would stop you before the wall. What it would do is, if it didn't have lines to follow, it would just make you keep going straight. And then if your nose of your car was going into a wall, it would try as best it could to stop you before you hit the wall. But it tries to follow the lines. So that wasn't so bad. We made it. Do I have to drive down that alley with the truck?
Yeah, I would do. Yeah, you know, it's the language that makes me nervous, James. It tries to follow the lines. Not it follows the lines, but it tries to follow the lines. And that just reminds me of like a five-year-old kid, you know, in class where they've done like a really shit drawing and they bring it home to show you. And you just kind of like, you know it's crap, but you just go, very good, Timmy, very good. You've tried, and that's the main thing. And that's kind of how I feel about this auto drive stuff. Almost like, you know, you try to stay in the lines, but whoops, you're into a canal. You know what I mean? Like, it's not...
I can see that. But I think that trying is a pretty big deal. Especially when you're five. Now, if you're trying to drive into a ravine, then there's something really wrong with you. But if at least it was an accident that you drove into a ravine, then there's hope. So,
at least you tried.
At least you tried. There's a huge difference, because if you're not trying to avoid driving into the ravine, then you're trying to kill somebody. You can't argue that logic.
I can't argue with it. I can't. I do enjoy your almost innocent view on the world, but sometimes it's
oh,
great.
Shit!
Still on me, Bagley.
Yeah, I should probably mention that people are going to shoot at you at this point, so you might want to might want to get into some kind of cover.
Oh! What do you mean, don't panic? Oh, that guy too.
So remember B, snap into cover. Snap into cover. Use B to snap
into
cover.
Okay, snap into cover. This is
now second thing.
I feel like I was not warned that this was a dangerous mission. Everything so far has been going.
I'm sorry, I got distracted by the old conversation there. The other advice for you is, if you see any drones trying to attack you, disable them as quickly as you can.
Okay. If you see any drones trying to attack me, give me a heads up so that I can disable them.
Yeah, I don't see any at the moment, but there was one a minute ago. But yeah, for the moment, just stay into cover. Yeah, just...
There's one! Oh my god! Danny! I don't want to die!
Cover. So use the disable hack on the drone. I think it's behind you.
I'm not familiar enough with how to do it.
Just literally just look at the drone and just press left bumper on it.
Okay, left bumper, disable.
There you go. Yeah, good. Right, okay, the data is downloaded now, so Bagley's about to blow the truck up, so just run away.
Oh, thank God. What is that? Is that another drone?
No, the truck is about to explode.
Oh.
Now we just need to run away, so steal a car and leg it, I guess.
Well, that was fun, wasn't it? We pulled off a heist, made life a bit harder for the tyrants of the world, and most importantly, I got a new toy to play with. Now, run along back to the safe house. Sabine wants you and your new teammates for a briefing.
Well, that was, gosh, that was...
I'll be honest, I thought you were done there. I thought you were going to get killed.
I did too. It went from like just thinking that we were having a good time playing this casual sandbox game to all of a sudden I thought everything was done. That was a wrap for Danny here.
To be fair, I don't think I would have been too sad about it. But he's literally the worst character we've got so far.
I like him.
Well, with his just an incredibly deep Irish voice.
Just like, it's weird.
Have fucking killed her, you know.
Now, I wasn't the one hitting that person with the car.
Mom, this is To be fair, the pedestrians in this game are so stupid. Like, they rather than try and avoid you, they just run into you. Like, they'll just dive into the road. It's ridiculous.
That is sometimes how I feel like pedestrians are in real life here in Los Angeles, at least. Anytime you need us. And honestly,
I can believe that.
Kind of the way that I feel. Like, if I have a crosswalk, I will step in front of a speeding car because I have the right of way. Not if it's a light, if there's a green light, but if it's just a crosswalk with no lights, then I'll just step out and I know that the car has to legally stop.
You know what, I used to do that, so like in Britain we call them zebra, like that's a zebra crossing. Legally, like, pedestrians have a right of way on those, so like cars have to stop for them. So I used to be like you, I just like, this guy's clearly just gunning for the zebra crossing, I'm just gonna step out on the road and piss him off. Like, it's a stupid thing to do, but it's so satisfying.
It is satisfying. Yeah. But you know what? I'll say I'm not a hypocrite. When I see somebody coming up to a crosswalk, I always stop for them. I never, and anybody that's ever said otherwise, I never hit pedestrians on the road, period. Okay, so
you can just get out of the car, by the way, because you're just going to go in a big circle, of course.
Okay, I guess that's true.
The sat nav just sends you around in a circle when you try and...
The underground. Is this a specific place or is there multiple undergrounds?
So the London Underground, there's hundreds of stations all across London. But, like, you see the architecture of this building.
Yeah.
Is a very classic 1920s design for London Underground stations. So quite a lot of London Underground stations have that. So they have, like, the maroon tiling... And they've all got that same design.
Is it where they have, like, raves and dances and stuff?
No, James, it's where you get the train.
I thought the underground was, like, where there was, like, it was, like, dance clubs and, like, almost like a speakeasy.
I see what you've done, yeah. And you're thinking of, like, you know, when rappers are going on about Straight from the Underground and all that kind of thing.
Yeah, that's
not the same.
I was going to say, they don't keep it very DL. In the U.S., we keep our underground really under wraps. All right, so the underground's a train system. We call those the subway.
Oh, you've actually killed me, James. I'm sorry. What the fuck?
All right.
I'm here going on about this like this beautiful 1930s architecture, which was inspired by the Victorians, and then you're just going, yeah, and this is where they have the raves, right?
I thought that was like, I don't know, in the 60s, I picture like Austin Powers like hanging out at the underground. I don't know. I guess I had I guess I didn't understand. It was just transportation.
To be fair, enough dodgy stuff goes on the underground that, you know, you can be forgiven for thinking it, I guess.
I mean, look at this place, Danny. This looks a lot more like a setup for some sort of rave than it does for a subway.
Yeah, but that's because you're in the DedSec bunker. This is just the game. This isn't real life. Okay. Like, the London Underground doesn't just have a load of creepy mannequins just placed all over the platforms.
Well,
just
I haven't been there. You're supposed to guide me on these things. If I've misunderstood something, that's more on you than me.
James, come on now, you're being unfair. Like, there's a certain degree of common sense. It's not like I would turn up to Los Angeles and be like, oh, there's not enough weird mannequins on this tram platform. Or trolley car.
No, there is plenty of weird mannequins on tram. Like, what you'd be surprised at is how often you saw stuff like that. But it's Hollywood.
Well, it is LA, I suppose. Fair enough. Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, moving on.
Yo, I can't believe we just, like, DedSec or whatever. With no initiation or nothing.
Yeah. I wish we had the time to prepare, but the job needs to be done.
I love his voice.
Hey, the other day, yeah, I tried tailing some Clan Kelly hoods through Camden. Man spotted me in, like, 2 seconds. I got up my game.
Yeah, I understand.
We're playing for keeps now. Hope we're up for it.
It does not fit the face either. It's ridiculous.
Like as if one of his parents was like an orc or something. Like, the other was totally human. Totally human, but one was an orc. Reporting for duty. So am I supposed to interact with that, or is that just a suggestion? Answer the
No,
call.
I think that's... Yeah, that's what you have to do. Yeah.
Phone booth.
This is a...
Oh, I thought there was a phone
This
booth.
Is a, just as a interesting fact, is a... That is a tube train there. Like, that's an underground train.
This?
Which... Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that looks like
Which has
like
been
that,
converted into...
That holds up. That looks a lot like the subways here. A little less graffiti here.
Okay, calm down. The real one doesn't have graffiti. This is just the game.
Well, ours has some graffiti. It just doesn't have that much graffiti. Do you guys have a lot of graffiti and taggers? Like, do you have people tagging all over the place?
Well done, team.
Yeah, we have a lot of graffiti artists and stuff like that, but like most of them are just kids who just can't even spell their own name.
Yeah.
And they just, you know what I mean? But for some reason, like in this country, like they're very fussy about it. So like if a train has got like a tag on it, they won't put it into service. They just keep it out of service until they take it off. Like they're very fussy about it. They just, yeah. So you never ever see a train with a tag on it because they just won't run it if it's got a tag on it.
Wow. Does that mean that you guys don't have very consistent train times? Like sometimes you just wait for hours because no trains have been left untagged?
Yeah, they would rather cancel the train than run it with a tag on it. That's how ridiculous it is.
There are tags for all of our buses, all of our trains, and sometimes they use... I don't know if you've heard this story, but I confronted a tagger one time on a train and he pulled a box cutter on me. They're pretty serious about it. Like, they don't want you to mess with them. And I'll never again will I tell anybody tagging anything to stop. I'll just let them do it. But they do strange things. They'll take knives and they'll tag their names in like, the windows are like plastic, but they'll use knives to scratch it in, you know, totally ruin stuff. Can't wipe
oh yeah, they
scratches.
Do that on bus. Yeah, they do that on buses and stuff. Like you'll see that. Like you'll see them scratching into the windows because you can't really, without replacing the window, you can't really fix that. I don't think.
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty scary that he pulled a box cutter on you. That's
oh,
pretty
it
good.
Was a nightmare, Danny. In fact, the story's pretty good. I'll tell the tale. But let's get started on the mission, and then I'll tell it during that.
Picked up an encrypted signal from the Tone conference site that's been broadcasting on a loop since the night of the bombing. Go investigate. You might even get to try out that fancy new AR tech we stole. I mean, creatively shared.
Do you think I should just stick with this character, or should I swap out?
I think we should. I think we had a request in the comments to do a different character every day.
Oh,
so
well
we
then
should.
Let's
have
try
we got
more.
So, have we got?
No.
Yeah, let's. Have we got somebody we haven't actually used before?
Yeah, we'll take Mortimer. So, do I do that through the team?
Yeah, so if you go to the team menu, and...
potential recruits. Oh, yeah, I remember. But this one, Mortimer's good.
Mortimer Edison. Yeah, he's got quite a lot of good skills. That's cool. That might come in handy for this mission, actually.
All right, so does that mean...
So go back on the menu. So you hover over him and then hold that.
Oh, swap operative. There we go. All right.
Excellent. Our little posse's growing. Welcome to DedSec.
Damn right. Man's ready to tear it up.
Fantastic.
Fantastic.
All right. The signal source at Toan attack site.
Oh, I quite like his MS-DOS bag.
Oh, that's awesome. I didn't even notice that. That's cool. So I was leaving Activision on Ocean Park Boulevard out here. It doesn't really matter. It's actually technically Treyarch. Treyarch and Activision's buildings are like not even a block away. They share one corporate parking lot. and usually we'd work, you know, a typical 8-hour day when it's not crunch time, 12 hours when games are close to release, and then just insane hours. But sometimes if you're working, and this was when I was working at Activision, you'll go home at like an early time. They'll have nothing really to work, and they know that they're trying to avoid OT later, so they'll send you home. I had gotten off of work, and I was leaving at like, I don't know, like 4 o'clock in the afternoon this day. So the kids were getting out of school, and I was on a bus, a city bus, with a whole bunch of, you know, school kids, and at the same time there was some just like. I was probably in my late 20s at the time, and there was somebody else that was probably in their early 20s, maybe like 20 years old, maybe. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I don't want my gun out. Okay. I'm going to select this in the map before I go forward. So I was leaving on the bus with a couple other people that worked with me on the Guitar Hero series. This is back when Guitar Hero World Tour was being developed. And on the bus, there was kids, because it was earlier in the day than usual. They were coming home from school. And then there was one guy that was in the back using whiteout to tag the bus seats. And he was just like putting whatever, I don't know. Nothing cool, not like cool graffiti. He was putting some initials with whiteout on a seat. And I'm sitting there, and there's these kids, and they're all kind of looking, they're all looking at him, and they're all silent. Like, I can just tell that in their heads, they're like, why is that person doing that? So I said to him, I said, what are you doing? And he responded to me, like, what business is it of yours what I'm doing? And he said it in a pretty aggressive way of like, you know, leave me the fuck alone. So I responded to him, well, what business is it of yours? What business it is of mine of what I'm asking why you're doing that? And then the guy's like, you want to fight? And I'm like, no, I don't want to fight you. That's not what I was trying to say. But I was with some other people from Activision. And one of those people was like, yeah, we'll fucking fight you. We're getting off at Ocean Park and Main Street. And I'm like, oh my God, this is not what I wanted to do. So then while we're on the bus, this guy starts making phone calls and telling people to meet us at this place that we're getting off. And I'm just like, it is getting pretty heated on the bus right now. And when I'm getting off the bus, this guy's like getting off, and I'm telling the bus driver, I said, this person here is, oh, so I'm telling the bus driver, this is actually what happened, is before that happened, he wanted to get up and fight with me, and I was telling him, you know, I'm not going to physically fight you. There's no way I'm going to get into a physical fight over this. And, gosh, I'm going to have to resume this story afterwards, because otherwise I'm going to get killed in this permadeath game. Right?
I look forward to the conclusion of the story.
It is a good conclusion. I mean, it's not really a good conclusion. It's pretty close to the end of that story. I guess I can get a little closer.
I mean, the way I'm reading the story so far is that things have not gone the way you expected them to, and now you're regretting the decision to kind of approach this guy.
Oh, absolutely. Especially immediate regret. But honestly, I would say the guy was an asshole, and that guy should not have been tagging and should not have been wanting to physically fight me. But also, my coworker should not have said, "We'll fight you," and like given the place where we get off of the bus, which was just insane to do.
That was the dumb move. Like you couldn't have predicted that, to be fair.
No. Because this is back like when I was a lot younger. I still stand behind this. I do not believe in violence. I am an anti-violent person. I just simply don't believe that violence will ever solve a problem. I think that it's very possible that the good person would win with violence, but it's also just as likely that the bad person will win with violence. So I think as long as that's the case, you should not use violence to solve issues of right and wrong. And I stand behind that. But this other person did not believe that. And when I was getting off, I told the guy, I said, "I'm not going to fight you. Like, it's not going to happen." And while we were getting off, he had a box cutter in his hand, which I guess it's a box cutter. It's one of those little razor blades that's retractable out of like a hand size thing. And as he was coming up, I was like, "Man, this guy is coming up." So I told the bus driver, "This guy's got a box cutter. He's threatening to attack me outside of this." So the guy has the box cutter out. Now everybody on the bus is getting a little bit frantic. But he did put the box cutter away. And afterwards, the bus driver wasn't driving anywhere. She called the police, and we were waiting for the police to arrive. And the guy ended up punching me right in the face on the bus. And then left. And like, I never saw the other friends because it ended up being alleviated at when he punched me in the face. I didn't do anything about it. So the end of the story isn't quite as climactic, but it is, don't say anything because you might get punched in the face. So now if I catch a tag or doing anything, I just leave them be.
Or just not politely and walk in the other direction.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it sucks because I really feel like I was in the right. Like, you shouldn't be tagging public things. And I also felt like if I didn't say something in front of these kids, like, then to them, it's like, oh, that's just the way the world is. You can do whatever you want. So I felt almost a responsibility to say, hey, what you're doing is wrong. And that might just be my self-righteousness.
Well, no, I mean, in an ideal world, you're right. Like, you are right. Like, your point of view is the correct point of view. But the sad reality is like, if people, you know, some people are just aggressive, right? Like, you come across these people like that who they don't know how to have an intelligent conversation. They will just talk with their fists. And, like, you can't really win against that. So if someone's going to carry a weapon, or, you know, physically assault you, then, like, you can't win that argument, can you, really? Like,
no.
Unless you get the police involved or whatever. And I think that's the problem, isn't it? Like, so many people just don't get involved because they're scared of getting into a situation like you got yourself into. And that kind of, in a way, reaffirms his outlook on the world because basically he got away with it. You know?
Yeah, not only did he get away with it, but now going forward, I'm not going to say anything to anybody like that. That was my lesson.
You know what I mean?
I walked away learning a very powerful lesson. Like, you don't know if that person's carrying a weapon when you start telling somebody to, you know, mind their own business.
That's the scary. That's the sad thing about the world we live in, James. It's like, because in a way, like, he's right. He technically won the argument because, like, you know. Like you say, you go away with it. You're never going to question him again. So anyway.
So now I've used this. How long does it does not last very long? Here's the situation I'm in. I have no idea. Now that I don't have a spider drone, I don't know how to get over there. I see that there's something that's like a spider drone on the map. Is it possible that I have to jump over here?
No. Ooh. You can't. I don't know, actually. There might be a way. No, I don't think so.
Well, that was a dumb move.
My advice to you would be to circle the perimeter. So go climb. So there's some ladders over to you. Oh, you can go on the pier.
Oh, yeah, I didn't
have
see
a look around the.
Oh, I see the ladder, yeah, but I think this is faster. Yeah, yeah.
Basically, all you want to do is just surround. Just if you come in across gates that are locked and stuff.
Yeah.
See if there's any way you can unlock them. So like if it's a key card, then if you can obtain the key card by hacking cameras and stuff, then you know do that and unlock the gate. But if you can't get through the gate, what the hell?
I don't know.
Okay. You became one with the boat. Anyway, so if you can't get... right, so that one uses a key, right? So you see how like it's got a key. So
yeah, but even if I had the key, I couldn't just walk in there. Unless maybe I was dressed like the construction worker.
Oh, well, there's a good idea.
Could I switch right in the middle of a mission?
Yeah, you can switch now, I think. Because you haven't entered the... You haven't entered the zone yet.
It was nice to try to use that guy, but sometimes you just got to go with what is called for in the mission.
Yeah, that sounds reasonable enough. I mean, to be fair, using a uniformed operative is something we should do where possible. So, you know, if we've got a construction worker and we're going onto a construction site, we use him. If we're going into a police station and we've got a police officer on our team, we don't yet, but if we did, you know what I mean? It's smart to do that.
Do you think I can make this jump?
Wow. The fact you even asked me that question has made me angry, if I'm honest. Like,
oh, I'll walk around. It's just so close. I'll
compromise with you and say that you'll make the jump if you do it over the water.
I'll make the jump if what?
But if you do it over the water. If you jump into the river from there, you'll be okay.
Okay.
But don't jump onto the concrete.
Teamwork.
Okay. Well.
That's teamwork.
Reminds me of better times.
I'm still nervous about this, but I'll let you do it.
All right, we did it. That was really smart of you, Danny. Thanks for helping me on that one.
You're very welcome. I think what's worrying me more is the fact that you stood on a bridge that crosses a river and the place where you decide to jump off is above the concrete.
Alright, so I don't have the key, but I should be able to steal the key from somebody, right?
Correct. So if you try and hack the door...
Okay.
So hold left bumper on it. There you go. So now you've done that, you should see on your minimap the key icon somewhere. So yeah, you can see him there. He's right in front of you. See the key icon just over there in the distance?
I sure do. So it's a matter of finding something that can hack close to there. Oh, there we go.
Yep.
Well, this is nice. And... I would appreciate, just give me a heads up, if I walk into this place as a construction worker, they're going to think I belong there, right? They're not just going to start blasting me because...
So the rules are, since you haven't done this before, I'll explain the rules. So
okay.
They will generally ignore you unless you get too close to them, in which case they start to recognize that you're not supposed to be there. So keep far away from people. And the other thing is don't run, because they get suspicious if you run. If you get too close to a guard or whatever, they won't immediately recognize you, but they'll start to become suspicious and follow you around and stuff. So just try and stay away from people as much as you can, basically.
That makes sense.
So like the guy on your left is becoming suspicious of you.
Oh.
So so he hasn't become hostile yet, but he's following you.
Can I distract him?
So keep away from... Yeah, you can ring his... Yeah, 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 perfect. And now just get far away from him, so he's, yeah.
Oh my gosh, I'm pretty tough if I'm just able to, like, elbow my way around that. Okay. I think I got away from that guy. That's not gonna haunt me later, is it?
No, so you're okay again now. The music
and
in the background
gives you a clue. And I can use my cloaking to get around people for a short amount of time, right?
Yes, if you cloak, they won't see you at all. If they see you cloaked, they might become... Well, if they can see you and then they see you become cloaked, they might become suspicious.
Okay. Uh-oh. that was close. Did you see what happened?
Yeah, I saw you pull your gun out again.
I was trying to run, but I used the wrong button. Oh, good. I broke the line of sight. All right, here we go. Damaged spider bot leg. The leg piece of a damaged spider bot cover. Okay.
What the fuck? This is it. The signal is coming from this spider bot fragment. No indication yet who it belongs to.
Bloody thing's been knocked about. Why is it here?
Difficult to say, but with an AR reconstruction, we may be able to see what happened to it and if it relates to the attack. Access data relays in the vicinity, and I can compile enough data to build the AR reconstruction.
So now you have to go and hack the data relays. There's one you can get out of that. So yeah, there's one. So if you look on your right, behind you.
Yeah, that one. I was kind of trying to get myself in cover really quick before I take that.
Well, you don't really need to because you're in the disguise and no one's.
So they won't. While I'm gone, they're not gonna. Nobody's gonna find me.
No, you're perfectly safe there. Yeah.
All right. So there's three places that I need to access surveillance data. I think going up, I think there's one down here, right?
There might be on the other side, yeah. But if I recall,
yeah, there's
all...
one there.
Yeah.
All right. We should be able to get this. Go.
You seem to be picking this up, like the principles of it.
Yeah. It's intuitive. It makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, are you enjoying the game then, or like?
Oh yeah, I'm enjoying it a lot.
It's very polarizing, Watch Dogs. Like, some people seem to love it, and then some people just think it's crap. And,
No, I like it a lot. I like the whole futuristic and I know this is not cyberpunk, but it kind of is cyberpunk in the genre sense. I like this style.
Yeah, I'd say so.
The world that it's in. So I guess, should I recall my spider bot? Can I do that?
You can do. You can just back out of it and grab a new one. But you might as well keep the same one, I suppose. Unless you have a reason to do
it. I just feel like,
you think it'd be
well,
quicker?
I guess this isn't bad. I need to get upstairs, and I think it might be easier to just start back over to get upstairs. But then again, the guy that was guarding this door seems to be gone now. Oh, he's walking over there. I didn't even see him. This is good.
I can see you were tempted by that trap there.
I was. I feel like I deserve some sort of reward for just simply not arming it.
No, I was surprised that you held restraint, to be honest. I fully expected you to arm it, to be honest. So, well done.
What is that guy doing? Okay.
Walking towards your position.
Oh, this is not looking good. Well, actually, it's not so bad either. I'm going to get that data point before I even move on.
Oh, yeah, there is a cheeky data point over there.
All right. Wait, where is it? It must just be around this corner.
I think you have to crawl underneath the rubble from the...
Alright. I could do that. Where the hell is around it?
Yeah, I think you go through there.
cool. And I feel like this is pretty close to this other one. This is nice. Doesn't even seem like there's anybody over here.
No, I think you're good for the minute.
One more data relay and I'll have it.
These spider bots, and I have actually, and this is almost embarrassing, I've never seen Blade Runner, but it reminds me of the few scenes that I have seen from Blade Runner. Have you seen Blade Runner?
Yeah, I've seen Blade Runner before. Have you seen the new one that came out?
I haven't
last
seen
year,
either of
was?
Them.
Okay. I haven't seen the new one that came out the other year. I've obviously seen the original one from the 80s, which is a classic. It's really good. I feel like Cyberpunk is a lot more like Blade Runner than this is going to be. Like Cyberpunk feels very inspired by Blade Runner.
Yeah.
You know, like all the very tall buildings with all the neon lights and the big screens and all that kind of carry on. Like, I really can't wait to play Cyberpunk because, like, the world just seems to be, like, it's very vertical as well as horizontal. And yeah, I'm just really excited to go check it out, to be honest.
CTOS AR, data reconstruction in progress.
The AR in this game kind of reminds me of Superhot, but probably just the red and white color scheme. Oh.
Don't cuff the Kelly dog.
Mysterious figure and attackable.
As in Clan Kelly. It was gangsters that blew the fuck out of London.
I think that was a handoff. Like, the Kellys were the supplier.
But who the fuck is this? They're not with Clan Kelly. Are they with Zero Day or something?
Well, don't just stand there. Keep looking.
Okay, keep looking.
So if you look, if you look up...
Oh, that...
There you go,
spider
yeah.
Spider bot.
This is so dead set. Bagley, can you tell who's driving the spider bot?
I've now fully decrypted the signal the spider bot is broadcasting. And while I cannot identify a specific user, it is a call code used by the Metropolitan Police Service.
Fuck me. The guard was watching all this.
Oh, cool.
The reconstruction continues behind that rubble.
Bagley? Open a quantum tunnel, will ya?
Quantum tunnel technology is at least 10 years away, but spiderbots and drones are here today. You could try one of those if you don't feel like waiting.
Good idea.
All right, here we go. So I can take this. I assume this is the right direction, right? We're quantum tunneling the old-fashioned way?
Basically, yep.
Okay, just...
I'm trying to remember, you know, like, if spider-bots were a thing in real life, because I'm sure I've seen one before.
Right.
And, I think that would be a pretty cool little gadget to have for Christmas, like, just a spider-bot.
Oh, heck yeah. Oh, is that one of the packages to deliver, like we were talking before?
I don't know what that is. Actually, go and check it out. Oh, it might be a collectible of some kind. You might as well pick it up while you're here.
RDX nitrogen, and the exact same detonator system like the bombs that were planted at Parliament.
His Zero Day signature.
Well, that's grim. I think his hand was still attached to the briefcase.
Conference passed. So what is this? Is this just a collectible?
Yeah, I think it's just a relic, as they call it. Like they don't. Yeah, they don't do anything. They're just collectibles.
So you hired to quiet all the targets. Shut it. We're all on need to know.
So Zero Day pulled together multiple groups to do the bombings.
That's certainly one way to pull off a massive coordinated attack while remaining anonymous. Zero Day needed manpower and resources, but they needed them at an arm's length. And it doesn't take the world's greatest AI detective to see that both Clan Kelly and Albion benefited in the aftermath. Unfortunately, this is the most we can get out of the AR reconstruction. But if we could find the mystery officer who was spying through the Spider-Bot, maybe they could tell us more.
Escape the area. So all I gotta do is go back to him, and now it's just get out of here?
Basically. If you can get through the gate without being spotted, or without raising any suspicions anyway, then that would be what I would call a flawless execution of that mission.
Alright.
I don't want to jinx it before you actually make it out of the restricted zone. Like, I feel like I've wished the James Heaney curse upon us there, but...
I hope not. I really hope not.
All you have to do is walk to the gate without causing any trouble. I think even you can handle this.
Just gotta be cool.
It's just the fact you're not looking where you're going is worrying me for one.
Oh.
You've pulled your gun, James!
Okay, it's fine.
No.
Shit. Okay. Can I get out that door? Open?
Please do.
Open door? What is going on? Open door! Oh my god. We're good, right?
Oh my god, yeah, just run away, please. Oh, they've called for backup.
But that's not a big deal, because we'll be able to get out of here, right?
Just take that car and go.
Okay.
Oh, I knew it. I knew I'd cursed it. I knew it.
It was assigned to New Scotland Yard.
You did it, though. That was pretty much flawless.
It was flawless until the point I said it was flawless. And then, like, literally, I can't believe it. Like, literally, I said that you... you know what, James?
The only way to know for sure is to investigate New Scotland.
Well, here's the problem. Is I was trying to walk real cool, and I wasn't really watching where I was going. Oh, shit. And, oh boy, this is embarrassing. Let's just get away from this area. Oh, and
every year, I am genuinely speechless. I have no words to describe what just
well,
happened.
Well, I didn't mean to shoot that guy. I didn't mean to pull my gun out. I tried to distract him, but for some reason I pulled my gun out when I was trying to hit the distract button.
You know, like when something major is going down and you sort of feel like your life is going in slow motion.
Uh-huh.
That's kind of how that felt to me. It was like the guy turned right, yeah, and was like heading towards you. And I thought I can, uh-huh, like my life flashed before my eyes. I knew what you were gonna do. I said he's gonna come round this corner. James is gonna try and distract him. He's gonna pull his gun by mistake, and it's all gonna go down.
Are you sure that you didn't like will that into existence? Because that's like
subconsciously,
you describe. That's pretty much what you made happen, I think, with your mind.
I admire your efforts to defer blame to me, but I think it, to be honest, it lies on you as the only person.
I think it was
kind
of both of
right
our
now
faults. All right, I think that was something both of us should have been prepared for. I needed to get ready to distract that guy sooner. I didn't know he was coming around the corner, and because my life seemed to be going in slow motion, well, what was happening is my hands were still moving in fast motion, like real time, but I was experiencing everything in slow motion. It was bad, is what I'm trying to say.
I don't even know if that's possible.
Albion has made the station their own.
And the entire police service. So, but don't worry, if you're not pleased with your privatized goon squad, just take your business across the street.
As much as I hate the Mets, I'd rather have them around than this lot.
Not to worry, the only difference now is the uniform, assault weapons, and the fact they're motivated by profit over public service. Now, any record or information on the Spider-Bot will be further in.
So here's my London fact of the day for you. The building we're going to hack into now is called New Scotland Yard. And New Scotland Yard, if you've ever watched any British detective shows or any of that kind of carry on, is like the headquarters of the Metropolitan Police.
Oh.
And you have this big sign that you can see there, which kind of rotates around. It's like a triangle sign that kind of goes around. It's just on your right. There you go.
This right here.
So this sign is quite a famous thing. Like, tourists come and take pictures in front of it. And, like, whenever there's been a murder or a homicide, you know, you'll have a news reporter stood outside the big rotating sign of crime, just kind of going there. Yeah, like, someone was murdered today and the police are doing nothing about it. And, you know, that's my London fact.
I've heard of the Scotland Yard. I just didn't know there was the new Scotland Yard. Is there still an old Scotland Yard?
Yeah, so what happened was, is like the Metropolitan Police were based in a place called Scotland Yard, which was like an old Edwardian building. And when they moved into this new headquarters, they just called it New Scotland Yard. The old Scotland Yard is like the... I think there's a police museum there now, if I recall.
Navigate the spider bot from out of that room. I'll need a direct connection. I didn't realize I was going to get so involved so quick. I didn't mean to end the story, but it seems like
you didn't even need to walk into the building. You know, I'll be honest, and I hate to say this again for the second time, but you flawlessly execute that.
Yeah.
That's literally all you needed to do. You can just hack that spider bot now.
I can just hack it right now.
Yeah.
Is this not going to...
That opening right there looks like a good exit point. Right, get comfy.
You're in like Flynn, as they say, and you did it all without stepping inside the building.
That's a good way to get through the state undetected.
Very good.
That's a part of the remote detonator system from Parliament. If the Met, or Albion rather, actually analysed it, they would see it wasn't dead sex handiwork at all.
In fact, apart from the slight incident at the end of that last mission, I would say so far, your performance this episode has been, dare I say it, exemplary. Like, you've done really well.
Well, thank you!
I'm always happy to praise my student where it's due. You know, I'm still scared, you know, that things are going to go wrong before the episode ends. But, you know, this mission is relatively straightforward. This is like a puzzling platformer kind of level. So you're
actually it's kind of a refreshing little change here. So
the thing I like about Watch Dogs is it kind of mixes it up with different mission types. So like sometimes it'll be like the last mission we did, which is a sneak and typical mission, but then you get ones like this which are like platformer kind of levels. You've got ones which are just you know, exploring places. Like it does mix it up a bit, which is good.
I thought I was going to be able to... I guess this is a glass window also.
Yeah. I'm not going to give you any clues. I want to see if you can figure it out.
All right. Oh.
I do like the little noises that the spider bot makes. Like when it jumps and stuff, it goes like, hop.
Oh, what is this? I guess I should analyze that.
That's Dalton's mask. It must have been recovered from Parliament. It might be the only thing left of him now.
So I'll give you a clue. You were on the right lines when you were on top of the glass cases, yeah.
Oh, I see. But how do I get up there? I guess this way. Oh, so the problem is this guy's almost dead. So his like ability to do stuff is not quite as good as usual. That's my excuse this time, and I'm sticking to it.
And that's a fair excuse. I'll give you that.
So in my mind, these spider bots should be able to walk on the walls.
Yeah, I kind of expected that.
Or at least an upgrade to do it later, like have like that as one of the top tier upgrades.
Yeah.
But maybe it would make the game too easy.
Maybe, but I mean, or even if you could only climb certain types of walls, or at least like fences and stuff. When I saw like the trailers for the game and they showed that there was going to be spider bots, I fully expected that, yeah, they would be able to climb walls and stuff. So it is a bit weird that they don't. Because why have a spider otherwise? Why not just put wheels on it?
Yeah, no kidding. But I guess wheels wouldn't be able to handle stairs, whereas this, it might not be able to... And wheels probably wouldn't be able to jump. So, as the devil's advocate, there are some advantages to having the different legs. Rather than be BB-8. Yeah, is that the character from the new Star Wars movies?
BB-8, yeah. With the roly buddy thing, yeah. I like BB-8. I quite like the new Star Wars movies. I know most hardcore Star Wars fans are not too fond of them, but I think they're okay.
Yeah, I'm not a hardcore Star Wars fan, but I like Star Wars a lot. I think The Mandalorian's great. I've heard a lot of people complaining about it, and I just think it's fantastic.
Yeah. I've not actually seen it, but I've heard mixed reviews on it. Some people seem to love it, and some people are like... I think it depends. If you're one of those hardcore, like, you have a very specific vision of what Star Wars should be.
Yeah.
It's like Star Trek, right? Like, it's got the same problem. Like,
I think I've told you this. Yeah. I've never seen a single episode or even a movie or anything of Star Trek. Nothing.
I just find that so weird. Like, don't you live in the 70s? Like, I'm so confused.
I should. But in theory, it would be probably one of my favorite shows. I don't know how it missed me. But I kind of am one of those people that if there's an episode one that's in black and white from the 60s, oh, I did not want to just jump down here, did I? Oh.
No, you did. You've done it.
Oh, that's good. I just realized I hadn't checked to see if I was going to be, like, spotted by somebody. All right.
The only downside to this is that you now have to go inside the building to collect the spider bot in person from the place where you just dumped it. So
that's not good.
This is the tricky part. Yeah. So, basically what you're saying is because the original series of Star Trek is so old and crap and like the sets are made of cardboard and you know William Shatner's acting is like hammy as fuck, you just don't want to watch it.
No, actually it's the opposite of that. That's what makes me want to watch it, but it's a huge ordeal to go, like, I've got to really sit down. It's a big commitment, but I honestly think that I would like the old ones as good if not better. Like, I love the old Twilight Zone, one of my favorite shows ever. What is this that I would disable? Is it security?
Yeah, so you see, like, the scanners. Yeah, the laser scanners.
Yeah.
The archways. It turns that off.
I just turned it off, then. Is that guy just going to turn it back on?
Yeah, but the problem is, so he'll turn it back on. So you'll see the come back on in a second.
Okay. So what I could do is disable that, or distract him, and then disable that, right?
Yeah, so I would get yourself into the reception area where you're allowed to be. And then, yeah, distract him, turn it off, and then run through quickly while he's distracted.
All right. So I'm allowed to be in the reception area, even though... Is there a day-night cycle? If I waited long enough, would this be, like, daytime here?
Yeah, there's a day-night cycle. It doesn't really have any bearing on the mission, though, so there's no reason to do it. But yeah, if you waited long enough, it would become daylight again.
So I need to get through that and first distract that guy. Okay.
Yeah.
This seems like it's pretty... Maybe I should plan this out a little bit better, but...
So I would maybe turn the panel off first and then distract him and then run through. But do it quickly. Okay. So, like, press it and then... So tap LB.
Oh, so I think LB that maybe I can't distract him yet.
Should be able to.
Maybe. I don't know. So it's. So disable that. Distract. Disable.
Okay. Yes, now go quickly.
Okay.
And go straight up the stairs on the left. Right no, 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 no. No.
Oh my god.
No, no, there was a stairway right there. Just as you came through the gate. You just want to head up the stairs?
So, I'm sorry. I was having a hard time focusing on you because I'm really scared. There's stairs behind this.
Okay. Yeah, so you're behind the stairway now. So if you go back through those doors...
And I would see the red lasers if I was going to get in trouble, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's no red lasers. Just keep an eye out for any police officers.
Okay.
I can hear some footsteps. Yeah, yeah. So to your right is the stairs. So just swing up the stairs quickly is what
to
I would
my
do.
Right, like around here. Oh, right yep. There.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Hey, very good. I forgot you had that.
All right. And that's where I want to go.
So the drone, it's in that room, yeah.
Oh.
I don't think there's anybody there, so you're okay, I think.
Okay, I've picked it up.
Cool, 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 cool.
So then I just
all
got
you need to do
leave,
now is...
Right?
Accessing its internal yeah, device. You just do the same well, thing in reverse.
You should make yourself scarce. Unless you'd like to explain
whoa,
to your
whoa,
new
whoa,
heavily
whoa,
armed
whoa,
privatized whoa. Police force why yeah. You've broken into the station.
I'd distract him. He's distract. Yeah, there you go. Run. Go. Go, go, go.
Okay.
The problem is that he's going
there
to reactivate the...
There was an exit over here, wasn't there?
Yeah, can you get through there? Hey. That'll do.
Will it?
No. I thought it would. Are you still in the restricted area?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh my gosh. Sneak up on them and take them down. Oh no, no, there's another person there. Go back inside.
Yeah.
Go back inside. I'm not liking this situation. That's not good. I thought that door was too good to be true, to be honest.
Alright, so I just gotta go out the front door like I came in.
That's probably the easiest way. But again, you're just gonna have to time it right, so...
Alright, so that guy should... There seems to be a guy coming. Oh, he's above me. Oh, thank God. Thank God.
There's a guy.
So, let's.
Yeah. So I would
distract.
I would distract him.
Disable.
Yeah. And then just leg it. Run,
oh
run,
shit!
Run, run. Oh no! But that guy's there. Shit! Yes, that's not good. Yeah. So that's what I mean. So we need to time it. So we need to do that. But while this guy is walking
what's
away
happening?
From us, rather than. He's become a bit suspicious. That's a good
just
strategy.
Surrender.
Oh, just run through the gate. They've seen you. Shit. Just leg it. Just go.
Okay.
Ah! Oh. Just James.
That was not the way I thought that was gonna go. Did I make it away?
Not quite, but if you drive away quickly, you should be okay.
Please repair as soon as possible.
Oh boy, that was crazy, right? Oh, I think they're after me.
Yeah, I think you've garnered a bit of a wanted level there, to be honest. Yeah, because the barriers have turned orange.
Okay, so we're on foot. This isn't the worst thing. We can probably get away with this, right? Is this a dead end?
This is a dead end. And being on foot is probably not a good strategy. Not unless you want to get shot.
Well, I think I might be okay here, right?
For now.
I'm safe.
Yeah, yeah, you're okay. Yeah, you did it. Well done.
Can we call that one flawless also, or what?
So this isn't the Minecraft show, but I feel like I've learned a lesson today.
What is that?
And that, That lesson is that James is good at executing the missions, but he's not good at finishing them.
Yeah, I would say that's probably a very good assessment.
It's like you can do the sprint, but when you get into the last 500 yards, you know, it all falls apart. So that's something we need to work on, I think.
Hold on one second. Let me see how long we've been recording this one. So it's 1:10, and it still says something's going on. Should we continue?
I think we should. Digging I think we should past? Probably wrap it up there, to be honest. Yeah,
I think so too. I feel like that it's been more than an hour, and I feel like we can wrap this one up in the next video. So, as always, thank you guys all for watching. I hope everybody's heart's okay, despite there being some close calls.
And, well, we haven't killed anybody yet.
Nobody consequential.
Oh, did we actually kill somebody? No, we haven't killed anybody.
I don't know.
Yet, have we?
There was the scientist that I electrocuted when I got the spider pod, and then there's been a couple pedestrians that I feel like might have just deserved what they got because they were backing into traffic or whatnot. You know, not my fault.
Yeah, they're fine. I mean, we haven't killed any of our characters though, have we? This is what I mean.
No, not our characters. So far, so good.
Okay.
All
well,
right,
remember,
so,
kids, violence is never the answer. That's the second lesson I've learned today. So.
Yes, thank you. Thanks for picking up on that lesson, Danny. I think it's an important one.